over-deliver. This means be humble with your approach. Try to show your products in a humble way. We're not boasting about this, but then try to surprise in a positive way. Try to exceed their expectation, because satisfying their needs is basic. This is the default stage should be. But exceeding their expectation means going beyond their expectation.
Hey guys, welcome back to the Leadership Stack Podcast, the podcast for entrepreneurs by entrepreneurs to increase your leadership, teamwork, and profits. This is your host, Sean C., aka Mr. CEO at 22.
Selling is focusing on me. When I sell, I'm trying to focus on me, on my interests, on my goals. When I try to serve you, I will try to focus on your interests, on your goals, on your what is of value for you. Think about this. Why people will get into an agreement that is win-lose? The only way that they can get in a win-lose agreement because they are deceived or manipulated, and they realize this later. Nobody's shooting their feet. Why they will get into an agreement? And what I always tell my clients is to avoid all these conditions that are hidden in contracts, what we call the fine print. Not good. When customers discover this, they're very annoyed, very frustrated. And when they discover this and they feel trapped, what is very bad from the customer perspective, they try to look for alternative solutions. They try to look for other suppliers. They try to look for other companies. And if possible, if they can leave this company, even might be costly, they will leave negative reviews all over the internet. So we do not want this. We do not want manipulation. We always want to be transparent, not misleading customers, not forcing them to buy something that they don't want, because this is what we call cognitive dissonance. It means customers feel regretful. Then they try to return the product. In some cases, they cannot return the product. You cannot return a service. And in some cases, if they cannot do anything, they might leave very negative review. This will be negative ambassadors promoting your company in a negative way.
We call them here as detractors. And detractors. You're right, right? You when you do that, when you have a win-lose, you lose the customer right there and then, even if they signed the contract and gave you their money.
And win-lose doesn't mean only win-lose with this customer. So you will, first off, this customer is losing. You are winning. But you will lose this customer, and you will lose potential customer that could have come if this customer was satisfied. If the customer was satisfied, they could have brought to your company additional customer. So you're not only losing this customer, but you're losing other potential customers. So remember that every customer has a network. And when you satisfy a customer, this customer is more prone to recommend the company to the network. The opposite happens when you don't satisfy. I always use a very interesting quote from Tom Peters that he always observed, the famous management guru. He observed, always under-promise and over-deliver. Under-promise and over-deliver. This means be humble with your approach. Try to show your products in a humble way. We're not boasting about this. But then try to surprise in a positive way. Try to exceed their expectation, because satisfying their needs is basic. This is the default stage should be. But exceeding their expectation means going beyond their expectation. I always tell my clients a very simple example. Here I'm based in London now for many years. And in London, you have different coffee shops, the big chains. And I'm half Italian, and I observe that some coffee shops are very customer-oriented, very compassionate with their clients. And for example, I went to a coffee shop here, and I asked for a cappuccino, and this waiter told me, oh, go to the table, I will bring the cappuccino. 15 minutes later, they brought the cappuccino. Cappuccino was cold, brought late, didn't meet my expectation, didn't even satisfy my minimum needs. I went to the competitor, the other company, a big chain too. And I went there, and they asked me, oh, your cappuccino, similar price. They said, oh, we'll go to the table. They brought 1 minute later the cappuccino, hot. And then the waiter left, and they said, no, sorry, you are forgetting a tray with biscuit. No, I'm not forgetting anything. This is a gift for you. Gift for you to enjoy with your cappuccino. First company didn't even meet the basic needs. Second company exceeded the needs. Which company do you think that I'm going back now?
Definitely not the first one.
It's not the first one. So it's quite obvious. But little gestures make a lot of difference, because when you are generous, when you're focusing on them, because you are serving them. You're not selling. You are serving them. You're making them feel comfortable all over the purchasing experience. Because customers want to feel comfortable not only when they got the product, before buying the product, during the buying process, and after buying the product. We call this touch point. During the buying process, customers should be comfortable when asking questions, when checking the condition, when asking for about uses of the product or risk involved with the product. So, well, all these questions should be clarified. And also before buying the product, the customer also have enough information to make a very well-informed decision. So, and after buying the product, customer should be also open to ask for a clarification on how to use the product or clarification how to return the product or get a refund. So company should bring about positive emotional experience all over the process. Satisfaction of needs has an emotional basis. So when you satisfy customer needs, this means that they feel well about your product, your service, and your company. So it means that they tend to love your product, tend to love your company, and they're more prone to recommend your company. Instead, when customers feel dissatisfied, they experience negative emotion. They feel angry, they feel resentful, all negative feelings, and this negative feeling drive customers to look for other products, to get revengeful, to leave negative reviews online, negative word of mouth, and this is very bad for the company, and also it's pushing away all customer, potential customer that might come in the future.
That's true. I agree with that 100%. Well, Doc, I feel like you are doing well because of your attitude, because Thank of you. How you serve customers, because of your principles. And I want to know, for those companies out there who, regardless whether they are compassionate or not with their employees, are having a very difficult time because of the pandemic, what would be your one big advice to them?
Very important. Try to always focus on, again, on the human being. Try to look at the needs that are not satisfied, or employees that are dissatisfied, in the case of employees, or customers that are dissatisfied. How can we address this need in a much more effective way? What is missing? For example, if employees are complaining that during the pandemic they have some problem with time, work time. Can we offer employees to work from home or offer some flexible work time? Can we offer them to, for example, start working during the day later and finish later? Can we be more flexible with them? Can we offer them, for example, if they have a lot of time that is devoted to meeting, can we reduce the number of meetings? Can we ask them? So asking employees what needs are unmet. So this will be the first important point. So generally, a good solution starts with a good question. This is my tenet in life. A good question brings about half the solution, at least half the solution. So asking employees what needs are unmet and what are their fears also, because during the pandemic, you have a lot of fears, anxiety, how they can feel much more at ease, how they can experience what we call psychological safety. So for example, they might need to work, for example, some days part-time and also some other days full-time, or they might need, for example, to reduce the number of meetings or have training that is much more simple and oriented. Some employees, in some cases during the pandemic, they don't use any technology, for example, like MS Teams or software like Zoom. Well, do these employees need training regarding this? Can we train them in a way that they feel much more comfortable, much more connected? People, we have to understand, pandemic implies social distancing, but doesn't mean emotional distancing. We need to be connected. We have to develop trust and cooperation bonds with employees and with customers. So we are not disconnected as human beings. We are still interdependent. No pandemic can take away our interdependence. We are interdependent, and employees and all human beings have the need for affiliation, means being connected to others. We are sociable and social beings, so we need to be connected to others. Also checking if the employees have additional difficulties outside the work time. And also to customer, in relation to customer, well, I will also, because many companies are selling online during the pandemic, this is growing up very quickly. Even when you have a very good online platform, I always tell my clients, can you connect to customer offline in certain ways? Do you have a helpline? Do you have a telephone number that customer can talk to you if they have any problem? They cannot go to the shop in some cases because the shop is closed down. But what happened? They're selling online. Well, can we have another way of video conference so that we can talk person to person? If customer have some doubts, they have some needs, or they have some complaints, very important. So, and also two questions that I will suggest leaders to ask themselves, and also employees also, to how can I be more generous during these challenging times? How can I be more grateful? How can we support one another? Because we have a common goal, that is fulfill our objectives, satisfy our needs, but we can do in a way that everyone needs are met, everyone expectations are met. So how can we help one another? Try to think about the, not only about us ourselves, but also think about others. How can we support one another?
That is really critical for a lot of companies to know during this time. Thank you for that, Doc. And before we wrap up, where can people get in touch with you?
Okay. Oh, thank you very much for the question. Well, I have two websites that are www.brunosignaco.com, and the other website is www.humanorientedenterprise.com. And they want to know more about these ideas, they can check in any bookshop, online or offline, my new book, that is The Art of Compassionate Business, published by Routledge, that can be found worldwide.
Awesome. And we will have that in the show notes. If you go to leadershipstack.com/podcasts, look for the episode with Dr. Bruno Signaco, and you will find all the links there. If we can find your other social media links, like LinkedIn, I'm sure you have a LinkedIn account, but if you have other social media accounts, my production team will have it there, linked below. Doc, thank you so much for your time. We have learned so much and we are better for it.
Thank you very much for your invite. I feel very honored. Thank you.
This episode is partnered up with Armory.ph. Armory is an online watch store and is the exclusive distributor of the brands TW Steel, D1 Milano, Fonderia, Luminox, and Mondain in the Philippines. Yes, folks, those are Italian watch brands. If you are looking to buy your next go-to luxurious everyday watch, go to armory.ph and enter the coupon code LS30. Armory.ph delivers straight to your doorstep with a security tape to make sure that your package is safe from theft, arrives on time, and is guaranteed working 100%. Go to armory.ph and buy your first luxury watch today.
I needed a lot of practice and I hated speaking. That's why I don't believe in the saying, yung follow your passion, kasi it should be follow your hard work.